doesn't love hanging outside or chilling on the beach on a bright sunny day? I love it. We know reptiles love it too, especially the ones here at Alligator Adventure in sunny South Carolina. These guys use the rays to heat up their cold-blooded bodies and warm up their muscles so that they're ready to do some hunting. But not every critter here feels the same way about the sun. These rare and amazing ghost-like creatures are the exception. Hey, what's going on? Hanging out here at Alligator Adventure in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Today, we're going to be talking about their albino alligators. So stick around. A good portion of my life has been all about action, which still holds true. But now I pour all that time and energy into wildlife conservation, education, and the pursuit of knowledge. This is Kamp Kenan. We're inside the albino alligator enclosure here at Alligator Adventure. I'm with Travis Correll again. And Trav, man, these are really beautiful animals. I'm really not one for morphs, okay? I'm not really a morph guy, but when you see a white gator, it definitely has a ghostly appearance. And you've named them, what are their names?
Casper and Wendy.
There you go, just like the cartoon. Now these animals, the history of the albino alligator, they actually were first found in Louisiana, and you guys, Alligator Adventure, acquired these animals from a farmer in Louisiana?
Yep, back in 1989 when they were first found. We originally owned the world's largest collection back then, of seven.
Wow, seven animals. And you know, something fun for you folks now, you see this bearded, strapping lad, but how long have you been working here?
Almost 20 years.
20 years working in Alligator Adventure, so how big were these guys when you started?
He was still full grown. This girl right here literally was like a foot and a half.
She was a little gal, huh? So you've been working with Wendy for a long time. You know, what are some of the differences when raising and rearing and keeping a white gator and albino gator as opposed to obviously a gator that has melanin in its body?
Well, you just said the key word right there, melanin. These guys, they have none in their skin. So crocodilians' natural reaction is go outside, sun themselves, thermoregulate their body temperature. These guys want to do that, but they can't do that. If they go outside, they'll basically sunburn.
Oh man, now I know there's some breeders down south. I want to give a shout out to my friend Greg Graziani. Just produced his first white alligator, his first albino alligator, and it was a long time to make that happen for him. So part of the reason is these animals can get sunburned. Mm-hmm. So a lot of guys, what they're doing is they tend to have a lot of canopy when they're keeping the animals outside. But that being said, you still get to see some kind of little burn on the animals. So that's why in this enclosure, it's completely protected, a little bit dark, and it's almost like they're a different species. I was making a joke earlier. It's like they're a cave alligator, you know, like
a cave gator,
you know. It's just something that, you know, it plays tricks on the brain. And the really cool thing that I'm noticing is just, I love the way the eyes look on the white, the albino gator, man. So what else are you doing maybe differently for these guys as opposed to some of the others?
Just indoors. I mean, they pretty much get almost the exact same diet. They get spoiled a little bit. We give them a lot of large rodents to eat and everything, unlike the gators that we have outside. They get primarily chicken. But basically, the structure, I mean, this is the biggest difference between outside gators.
What kind of fun enrichment stuff do you do with these animals? Is it usually during feeding time you kind of get these animals all stirred up?
Yeah, we taunt and feed them and everything. Okay. We come in with a bucket and we'll bang the bucket on the ground and they'll both come up and we'll just feed one at a time.
It's amazing, you know, crocodilians are really smart animals. I mean, here we are, there's three folks in the enclosure, and these animals are making no move to come at us or come for food because they know the tongs aren't present, the food isn't present, so there's really no need to interact with us. And that's something that a lot of people, maybe some of the public out there, they really get nervous of gators, and you should have a healthy respect for alligators, okay, that being said. But they're not marauding people killers, not like some of the other animals that we'll see in episodes to come here from Alligator Adventure.
Oh yeah, we're gonna have an adventure.
We're gonna have an adventure. Stick around for some more exciting stuff on Kamp Kenan. Thanks so much, Travis, again. Yeah, I really appreciate your sharing your time and knowledge with us. And oh, by the way, there's a bunch of albino catfish in there too. It's a very cool albino motif they set up in here. But nice meeting you, Casper and Wendy, and we'll see you guys soon. Check out Alligator Adventure next time you're in Myrtle Beach. You'll have a great time seeing some of their amazing specimens.